Thank you, Madam Ambassador. Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great privilege for me to speak to this audience, and I'm grateful to you, Madam Ambassador, and also to you, UNITAR Deputy Director, Mrs. Alex Mejia, for inviting me to join this panel of eminent speakers. We are living today in a global context which is marked by unprecedented threats to peace and security, requiring effective synergy of the international community to minimize these dangers. But the solutions to this crisis, of course, are neither simple nor quick. The 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development represents a new commitment to global action, inspired by values and principles of the United Nations, and integrated response to the challenges of today. The foundations of such actions have been laid through a number of important international initiatives, of which the initiative put forward by His Majesty King Abdullah II of Jordan at the UN General Assembly in 2010 has been of a particular importance. This initiative later transformed in the UN General Assembly Resolution 65/5, unanimously adopted on the 23rd November 2010, which proclaimed the first week of February of every year as the World Interfaith Harmony Week. And so this is where the notion of respect for diversities comes into play, and this is where the concept of multiculturalism becomes relevant and starts to matter. Madam Moderator, my own country, Azerbaijan, is proud of its history and a diverse cultural heritage. Located at the western shores of the Caspian Sea and bordered by Muslim Iran and Turkey and Christian Armenia, Georgia and Russia, this country of 10 million mostly Shia Muslim have developed a centuries-long tradition of acceptance of its numerous ethnic and religious minorities. For example, in Azerbaijan, on one side, we can find one of the oldest mosques in the world, the Juma Mosque, built in 743, and on the other hand, one of the oldest churches in the Caucasus, the Caucasian Albanian Apostolic Church of Kish, which was built in the 12th century, and the Atashkah Zoroastrian Temple of Fire Worshippers, which was built in the 17th century. Throughout its history, Azerbaijan has always been a multi-confessional and multi-ethnic country. In the period of the Azerbaijani Democratic Republic, which was established immediately after the collapse of the Russian Empire in 1917, which became the first secular democracy in the Muslim world, women in Azerbaijan, for example, were already granted the right to vote in 1918. Thus making Azerbaijan the first Muslim country ever to enfranchise women. Located at the juncture of Europe and Asia, Azerbaijan has always been committed to multiculturalism, which is, from our point of view, the most important asset for peace, diversity and harmony in our society. This country has established necessary legislative conditions for all ethnic groups and confessions to exist in harmony with each other, to preserve their cultures, traditions, languages and cultures. Today, the historical monuments of all religious and ethnic communities are protected by the state. And the development of multiculturalism at the state level in Azerbaijan is a state policy, and it's based on an ancient history of statehood and on the development of these traditions at present. For example, Article 18 of the Constitution of Azerbaijan states that any religion in Azerbaijan acts separately from the government, and each religion is equal before the law, and religious propaganda abating human dignity is prohibited. Article 84 of the Constitution ensures the liberty of worship and the right to choose any faith or not to practice any religion at all. And the law of Azerbaijan of 92 on the freedom of faith ensures the right of any person to express his or her views on religion. Today in Azerbaijan there are more than 650 registered religious communities, among which 37 are non-Islamic. And, for example, the Orthodox Church in Azerbaijan is represented by Russian and Georgian churches. For example, the Russian Orthodox Church of Zhodnomyrdesets, which was built by Azerbaijani oil industrialist already in 1907 and was granted to the Russian Orthodox Church in 1991. Currently in Azerbaijan we have 5 Russian and 3 Georgian Orthodox churches. For example, the Catholic Church, talking about it, we can say that the Catholic missionaries visited Azerbaijan as early as in 1320. Following the visit of Pope John Paul II to Azerbaijan in 2002, the St. Mary's Catholic Church in Baku was inaugurated in 2008, because the previous one was demolished in Baku in the period of the Soviet Union 70 years ago. During another papal visit in 2016 to Azerbaijan, Pope Francis held an inter-religious meeting of the countries in the country's largest mosque, together with Orthodox, Catholic, Muslim, and Jewish confessional leaders. It has been more than 2,500 years since Jews settled in Azerbaijan. Currently, there are 6 Jewish religious communities registered in Azerbaijan, and we have 7 synagogues in Azerbaijan, including the one which is the biggest in the South Caucasus. There is also a Jewish school in Baku, which is the biggest in the Caucasus, which has been operating in Azerbaijan since 2003. As a consequence of national consensus and public support to multiculturalism, there are dozens of schools, cultural centers, theaters for all ethnic communities and groups living in Azerbaijan at present. And the Azerbaijani authorities also support dozens of magazines, newspapers, radio and TV programs in the languages of ethnic groups and minorities. As a part of this intercultural dialogue, Azerbaijan contributes also to the preservation of cultural and religious heritage across the world. Restoration works by Azerbaijan were carried out, for example, in the catacombs of St. Marcellino Pietro in Rome, in Italy, in the Cathedral Church in Strasbourg, ancient masterpieces in the Museum of French History in the Palais de Versailles in Paris, the Room of Philosophies in the Capitolino Museum in Rome, in the Louvre Museum, the Architectural Museum in Turnova in Bulgaria, and etc., which were all sponsored by the biggest charity organization of Azerbaijan, Heydar Aliyev Foundation, headed by the First Lady of Azerbaijan. The 2016 was declared the year of multiculturalism in Azerbaijan, and by developing its own brand of soft power, Azerbaijan promotes multiculturalism as a model for societies plagued by radicalism in recent decades. With this in mind, the Baku International Multiculturalism Center was established in 2014 to introduce the Azerbaijani model of multiculturalism to the world. At a later stage, its branches have been established in also in Bulgaria, Germany, Israel, Italy, Moldova, Portugal, Russia, and most recently the United States. The center is promoting